no. Oh, no. Where is he? He should have been here by now. Oh, hey there, kids. Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV! Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV!
Come on, this is crazy. Why isn't he here yet? Hey, kids. Sorry if it looks like I'm panicking. Because I am panicking! You see, we had a lot planned for Grow TV today, but can you guess where my co-host Andy is? If you guess anywhere right beside me, then you're right! He's not here! Now everything I had planned is ruined! Wait a minute. What if I did everything I was planning on doing with Andy, but just did it by myself? That's it! I can do that! Let's get started! First, we usually start off the day with a high five. Or a handshake. Or a hug. Alright. Next, joke time. Knock, knock. Next on the list is playing catch. Hey. Well. All that was useless.
Carl!
Andy!
I'm so sorry I'm late.
Where have you been?
I'm so sorry, man. I completely forgot we had Grow TV today. I was just at home feeding my pet tiger, and then I just realized what time it was, and I came home.
What? You have a pet tiger?
You don't?
No. I do not have a pet tiger.
Huh. Interesting. Anyway, I'm here to do all the things that we had planned today, all right? But first, high five! High five, Carl. Up top. I said high five. Carl, did you hear me?
I don't. Wanna. I don't wanna!
Why didn't you give me a high five, man?
I guess I'm just not in the mood.
Well, that stinks. Is everything okay?
Well, I guess I'm just a little disappointed.
What? Why?
I don't know. I guess I was expecting a really fun day, and then when I realized you weren't coming in, I tried to do the plan all by myself.
And?
And it didn't work!
Well, yeah.
What?
High fives, jokes, games, those things aren't supposed to be done by themselves. I mean, that doesn't even sound fun.
Yeah! It definitely wasn't.
You know, even Jesus didn't do everything by himself.
Really? Seems like he wouldn't need the help of the others.
Well, let's look at Mark 11. Grab the Bible.
You grab it.
You're closer.
Fine. Alrighty. Oh, this is where Jesus rides into Jerusalem.
It sure is. Jesus was heading there to finish out God's plan by saving everyone. But this was a very special time that a lot of people were looking forward to for a very long time.
Really? Why?
You see, what Jesus was about to do was predicted long before Jesus was even born.
Well, that seems to happen a lot with Jesus.
It's true, because Jesus was the savior and the king that all the prophets from the Old Testament had talked about. So what does it say happened before Jesus showed up in Jerusalem?
Well, several things. It mentions that some people went to go get some sort of key.
A key?
Yeah, a key to use when they were done. Maybe to open a door?
Let me see. Carl, it says they went to go get a don key. Donkey.
Oh, a donkey. I was gonna say, a donkey definitely is not a thing. But why not ride something more exciting, like a camel or an elephant?
The donkey was actually a symbol of peace at that time, and a horse would have been a good idea, but it represented a lot of kingdoms back then that weren't about peace at all. They were about war and stuff. Jesus wanted to show that God's plan would be about peace.
Then it says that once the donkey was with Jesus, someone put a cloak on the donkey so Jesus could sit on it. Well, then there are some people that took off their cloaks and laid them on the ground for Jesus. And others grabbed branches to put down on the ground.
You know why they did that?
Was it because it was laundry day and their clothes were too clean, so they had to dirty them up before they had to wash them?
Not quite. It was actually a way to show respect for people who were really important, like kings.
Like Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
That is so cool. Oh, look here. It even says people were singing to and about Jesus. They were worshiping God through all of it.
Yep, I'd say Jesus had a pretty good entrance into Jerusalem.
I'd say so too.
You know what I like most about this whole story?
Please don't say it was the key.
No, it was the fact that none of that would have ever happened if it wasn't for everyone pitching in and doing their part.
I mean, I guess you're right. I mean, you had people fetching donkeys, laying down their clothes and branches, singing. No way someone could do that all by themselves.
Not a chance. But God's plan for people wasn't just for them to participate in Jesus entering Jerusalem. It was much bigger than that. This king that they were welcoming into the city was going to save them and bring them closer to God.
So God's plan involved people, but it was also about people.
That's right. So even though I messed up today's plans and didn't make you feel included, just know you are always included in God's plans.
I guess you're right. I am included in God's plans.
Wait, that's our big idea.
No, it's not.
It is.
Are you sure?
Yeah, look at the script.
That's our big idea!
Today's big idea is I'm included in God's plan.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. Ready?
Ready.
One,
two,
three.
I'm included in God's plan.
Yes, I am. And so are you. And so is Andy. So the plan shall be moved forward. Hence now with God's plan.
Forevereth.
Forevereth.
And evereth.
Cooleth.
Well, Carl, we learned a lot today. But I hope you know I'm really sorry for being late.
No worries. I forgive you. But don't let it happen again. Or else.
Or else? Or else what?
I'm just kidding! Okay.
See you next week.
Watch your bag, Andy.
Who said that?
Oh, I don't know.
Did you hear that?
No, I didn't hear anything. Watch your bag.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Road.